As the political fallout against Liberal MP Rob Johnson continues, the Premier is refusing to act. However, Colin Barnett admits WA's emergency services are in turmoil and a high-ranking official needs to take the reins.
After only just surviving a motion of no confidence, Leader of the House Rob Johnson tries to get his members back inside Parliament.
Members can't leave the house.
Lock the doors.
I've never seen it before. If your own members won't come into the Parliament and you're Leader of the House and that is your responsibility, you have to consider your position. What's more, last night Kim Hames admonished him publicly.
With the Deputy Premier adding his weight to the political fallout and Liberal backbencher Murray Cowper admitting he's angry, pressure is mounting on the beleaguered Emergency Services Minister. Today, Bill Marmion refused to support him.
I'm not going to comment on another minister's portfolio. Look, I haven't been the Minister for Emergency Services. Look, I'm not going to rate anyone's performance. My role is to make sure that I'm a good minister.
The consequences from the Rowley Stone fires, in which 72 homes were lost, are continuing. After the damning report from Mick Kelty, a major shake-up is underway to ensure it never happens again. FISA boss Joe Harrison-Ward has been sacked. Chief Operations Officer Craig Hines knows he too may lose his job, and it's likely more will face the axe. Rob Johnson himself was unavailable for comment today, but it's understood he's meeting with FISA bosses next week to discuss what went wrong on the day of the fires and who he thinks should take the blame. The Premier is still standing behind his minister, but Colin Barnett admits someone else needs to step in.
We will move down the path of appointing a Fire and Emergency Services Commissioner along the lines of a Police Commissioner, someone in authority, in uniform, in charge.
Alice Pooley, 10 News.